Hello everyone, my name is John Melisondre and today I'm gonna teach you on how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So in this tutorial, I will teach you on how to paint this landscape with some houses, trees, rivers, and also I want to teach you here on how to paint water reflection. And please don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell button if you want to have some updates in the future. Before I'm going to start the tutorial, I'm going to introduce to you first the materials that I'm going to use. So I still be using Limited Colors my palette, and I have the titanium white, the hollow blue, the brilliant red, the medium yellow, and the umber. So I'm using Limited Colors because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. Okay, and these are the pastel brushes. I'll be using the number 12mm flat brush long handle, and also have here the number 10 bristle flat brush long handle, number 8 nylon flat brush long handle. I also have here the number 8 nylon flat brush short handle, and the number 1 liner brush for the details. You can also use 0 double zeros or 0000. Zeros. Okay, liner or brown brush. And this is my canvas. I think it is 13 by 16 inches. Or you can also 12 by 16 inches. I think I just made it a little bigger, but I think it's just the same size. And it has three colors: the prime, gesso, or you can also use white acrylic. I made it myself. And water to thin the paint. And we need water spray. If ever we need wet our canvas, and this will be easier for us to blend the colors. Okay, so these are just the possible brushes. And today I'm going to paint just a landscape painting with a big house on the center, and it will be near or beside the river. I'm gonna put a really nice reflection, trees or whatever that will come out of my mind. So I'm not really sure what will be the output of this painting, but I think I hope it will be good, and I hope it will be, you will be with me and through the end of the tutorial. And I'm not sure if I think it will take me more time because I have a bigger canvas. Okay, so I'm gonna start now, and I will be there for the paint. Okay, so let's do first the sketching. I'm gonna use the number 8 nylon flat brush long handle for the sketching, and some raw umber with white. So I'm going to mix these two colors here. So I'm going to mix it to make it a little lighter. So this is important, everyone. I don't want to use directly the raw umber because it will make my sketch very dark, and it will be hard for me to cover it with other colors, especially the yellow. Okay, so I'm gonna put it here. So I'm going to do a little planning first. Something like this. This will be a river bank here. And I'm gonna put the house here on this part. This will not be so big house, but I'm gonna do my best to make it look good. Something like this. And I'm gonna put a pathway here. This would be a really nice big pathway. With some trees and whatever that I'm gonna put there. I'm gonna also put the pathway a little here. So I'm gonna move so that I can put the very nice water reflection. Okay. On this part. So I'm gonna try it something like this. I'm gonna put some space for the water reflection because I want to show this on this painting a very nice water reflection. Okay, and so over here, I also put some other trees here, and also I'm gonna put plenty of trees in this part. On the back of these trees. And we can also see some skies. Yeah. And if ever I will put a big tree here on the other, on this side, this part. Okay, that's it. So I'm done with the sketching. So hopefully I'm gonna give justice to this painting. It takes me 7 minutes just to sketching, okay? So I have here the number 12 moon frog brush. I'm gonna do the sky first. Make sure it's a little wet. I'm gonna use some blue and white. More white. Yeah, I'm gonna put more bluish or purple in the sky. I want the sky to be more afternoon. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to get back this part here. Because we're gonna do the blockings first, or blocking of colors. Or something like that. And then I'm gonna use this blue here with some red to make some purple and another white. There. I'm gonna make the water purple. Okay, I like it. I like the color purple for the backgrounds. So I just want to block this part, everything, so that I can see where I'm gonna put the highlights or the reflection or whatever details that I'm gonna put later. So I'm gonna do this one first, blockings. Actually, this is very important so that we will know, so that we have directions on this painting. Then I'm gonna put some blue and red to make some purple. I must say that it will be more bluish, so I'm gonna put it in this part. I want this part to be really bluish to make it look more misty. Okay. And then I'm gonna put the reflection here. I'll just do it that way. And then I want more darker. Or darker, I'm sorry. So raw umber with the blue. I can put it in the background. Yeah. Black this part darker. Sorry everyone, if you just remember all the details that you put here, because we're going to do that later. Also put a little reflection for this one, like this. And then I'll put another lighter color using the raw umber with some white for this part here. Yeah, I need to make this part darker, but I'm going to make the house. I'm going to make the details of the house clear. So here I'm gonna use darker colors. So let it be that way here. You shouldn't remember what you put on the sketch. So I'm using now a smaller brush, and I'm gonna do now a darker blocking or making more darker colors for this for the background color. Okay, so I have here, I'm going to add a little green. I'm gonna put some darker greens here. So this will be some trees on the background, in the back of this house. I also want to put some trees here on the fronts, or yeah. Not just on the back, but fronts or whatever parts of the house. And I'm going now to use this bristle flat brush, yellow, blue, yellow, and raw umber. So we can do the topping technique here. That's pretty good. Yeah, I like this brush because I can create pretty nice tree textures or leaves. It will look like leaves. But we should not do this more here because we still need to put some details in the background. I still want to put some trees there. I don't know, some clouds. But here I'm gonna put more darks. Especially the raw umber. I'm gonna put more darks here. Okay, Yeah, we have now some black kings. And it's 20 minutes and I haven't. I'm very far from the truth. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to put some backgrounds first. It's actually a bad idea to put the background last, so before I'm going to put more details on the foreground, I need to put more details on the background. I'm going to make it more afternoon, so I'll be using this blue. Just blue and white here. Yeah, I want a little darker skies for this one. And some light blue also. I'm gonna put some light blue. And that's why it's a bad idea to put details on the trees, because I still have to cover that part there. I want it a little darker like this. There. Okay, I want a little reddish on the bottom part of the sky. So I'll just use red, add it to this bluish color here, and make it a little purple or reddish purple. And I want this part to be a little reddish. I want to put a little more clouds there. Yeah, this is really a bad idea putting, and because some parts are still wet, that will be a problem. You can turn the background greens. So I advise everyone that you need to let it dry first. Everything's still wet. I want to erase this part. And cover it with the background colors, okay? There, I want this bottom part to be more dark. Like this, okay? So I'm adding it, not so dark purple, but a little lighter. And also here. Maybe it really take me time to retouch this sky. So I'm mixing again another purple. Just all horizontal strokes, everyone. Just make it like this, horizontal strokes. Yeah. Okay. It looks good. I'm going to add more, a little darker. Okay, now I'm going to put some colors on the sky. So it's 29 minutes and I'm still in the sky. This is really bad. Okay, so I'm here. I have the red and the yellow and white. I just have to put a reddish color on the sky. Pintu at white. I adjust a little orange here. Just a little orange. Or a little red. I just want to put more reds here to make it this guy. I want it to be more colorful. Okay, that's it. So I'm gonna make this part a little darker. It's too light for me. I'm gonna use blue. Red with a little white. More red. I will just make this part darker. On dark. Yeah. And of course, I need also to make the reflection darker. I'll be using the same color. And another purple. I want it more bluish. And all you have to do is create those horizontal strokes, everyone, to create these realistic reflections. There. So just vertical strokes. Yeah. And again, I'm gonna make some orange, so yellow and red, and then white. Too dark, everyone. I need some more white. So we just have to create to make this part more yellowish. So I'll just copy everything what I see from the top, and it should always reflect on the bottom like this one. Sorry everyone. I'm gonna put some zigzag horizontal strokes here to create some reflections or some water disturbance or something like that. Yeah, but anyway, we'll just have to retouch that later. Yeah, and I'll try to retouch on the house, so I'll be using white, pure white here. So I'll put the lights coming from the left side, from the right side, I mean, sorry everyone. And I'm gonna mix for a little brownish red and raw amber and also yellow. So we have an orange. So this house have orange roof. And then I'm gonna put some gray walls. So I'll be using the raw umber here with some white. Also here. Okay, I'm gonna use some raw umber. So this will be raw umber and blue. So I'm gonna make this the shadow or casted shadow from the sun, okay, or from this wall here. Okay. I'm gonna put more dark, raw amber and blue. So I'm going to make this as the darkest part. If you have black, you can also use black, but I'm not recommending you to use black. Okay, and I'll try to put some tiny details like windows, doors. It'll be here. Yeah. Can actually change that everyone later, so don't worry about that. Yeah, that's a very nice house. Okay, I know I'm going to put, could start adding some leaves. So using this whistle flat brush, I'm going to try to use some bluish leaves on the farther part of this far is here. I'm going to add more blue and white. Yeah, just use tapping everyone. And I'm also need to use some brownish, so yellow and white, a yellow and red and white. And also here. I'm gonna put more little colors to make this part look more colorful. And I'm gonna use some white and yellow because I'm gonna put some highlights. And do not overdo it, everyone. Always remember that. Yeah. Okay. And then I will try to put some reflection here. This is the same color. There. And now I'll try to improve this one. I'll be using more darker colors first, so I'm gonna use some dark greens, just yellow and blue. Again, you can use the topping or punching. this one. I also want to put some brownish leaves, so red. So red, blue, yellow, more yellow, and blue, yes. This should be more brownish. And also here. Okay. I also need to put more bluish, so I'm gonna use some more blue. Yeah. And white. Need some yellow. Yes. Okay, just put it on the top of the bluest color. Yeah. Okay. And I'm gonna use yellow and blue, I think more yellow. And white. I'm gonna put reflections on this one. Oh no, I mean highlights. And in this one, I'm gonna make it more yellowish. I'll put more yellow. Just use this yellow here. Add more leaves. Add more highlights, I mean, everyone. Yeah, this is getting more interesting. And now I'm gonna use this orange, yellow, and red, and white. Thank you. I want more smaller details. So everyone just tapping and punching. And I will also put some more other colors like greens on this not just browns or other colors. So I also need to put greens there. And also dark colors. I'm gonna put raw umber and blue to make some darks. I want to put contrast on this one. That would be nice. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, so it's now 53 minutes and I'm not yet done. Sorry everyone, so I'm not really in a hurry, but I wanted to finish as early as possible. So I want to put more yellowish or orange color on the crown. Like this color here. Yeah, I just want to put more colorful painting here. I'm gonna put a little yellowish, just use the tapping technique. There, okay. And then more greens, I can also put greens. Another greens here. And then some white for a little highlights. Just yellow and blue. And we can create some a little highlights here. Yeah, just stopping. Yeah. And then I'm gonna put a little more highlights on this one. I want it to be more yellow. Yeah, I love that. I also want to put it here. Yeah, you can now see some colors there. And a very thick bushes or plants. Some white. You can see plenty of details there. Oh, that's nice. Okay, so here I'm gonna place some shadows here, lights. I want it to be really bright here. So I want to use very light colors, and I'll be using a smaller brush. This one. Number 8, nylon cut brush, short handle, and this one I want to make this part very, very white. And I'm gonna use some yellow and red and white, more red to make it more pinkish. I'm gonna put it here on the top. I want lighter. And now I'll be using some yellow and red. I want it to be a little lighter. This one here. More white. Or red. I want this to be, this part to be really intensely light. Okay, that's good. And I want some grays here with some white. I'm going to retouch the windows. There. Yeah. I want darker, so I'll be using the darkest color, blue and raw umber. And I'm gonna put darks on this part. Yeah, it's 1 hour now and I'm still not done, but yeah. So far this really looks good. For just 1 hour I make this one. That's good. Okay, I want the road to be really, really bright, so I will be using more white with a little reddish color. We should be careful on this part, everyone. It should be on the correct perspective. And also here. So I'm gonna put the light first. Yeah. And then I'm gonna mix for a little darker. I'm gonna put it on the top. Yeah, and now I'm gonna mix for darker, through umber and blue. I'm using a little darker color because this part should be darker. Of course, absence of light. And the shadows also. So these are some shaded part, some parts on the right side matte blocking on this one here. So it should be dark. Okay. So I'll put a little detail here. So this will be a cement pathway, everyone. So yeah, like the old times. Okay, so here I'll be mixing another dark colors for the shadow. It will be more bluish. I also need to put shadow here. I always want to put shadows on my works, and also here. So I assume that there is a tree here on the other side. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So I'll be using now some more brownish. So white, blue umber, yellow, and red. And this is brownish color. So I need to make this part lighter. And in some parts will be dark. I want it to be like just like that. Yeah. And brighter. I want more white. Yeah, this looks good. Okay. So now I'll be adding some reflection first for this part here. I'm gonna add some reflection. So I'm gonna add more bluish reflection, blue with a little yellow, but I want it to be more blue. So again, you need to have a downward stroke like this one to create this reflection, and follow everything you see in the top. So I'll just cover this part with bluish. Okay. And then I'm gonna use the raw umber and the blue. This is a really dark color. And I'm gonna make this part darker. I'm gonna put some rocks here. Rocks or soils or whatever found here. Okay, and then I'm gonna put some reflection. Just follow everything you see here on the top and put it on the bottom. Some horizontal strokes to make the paint even. Okay. Yeah. And I'm gonna make yours more bluish and white. So this part I'm gonna put some thickness. Yeah, but I need to put some, yeah, I need to refill some paints. And I'm gonna mix a darker color. So here, blue and red wombar. I'm gonna make this part darker. I want it really, really dark to create more contrast. And also here, I want it a little detail. And then I'm gonna use some more bluish blue under umber and white. So I think I'm gonna use a smaller brush. This will be for the shadow, everyone. For shadows, casting shadows. I will make it a little bluish. Here, I'm gonna make it a little bluish. So here I'm gonna cover it with more blue stone. So let us say it's not bluish, but more purple. Yeah, I like that. I'm gonna put more brown and also this one here. Let's make this a little lighter. I'm gonna put some rocks or details here. Yeah. Okay. That looks good. And then I'm gonna make it a little darker because this part, I want this part to be really, really dark with shadow. to again blue and blue umber. So let me make the color darker. There. Yeah. Yeah, so far it really looks great. I really love the light on this one. Yeah. And now I'm gonna put some reflections. I really love to put reflection on this the painting because it looks like a final retouch. Here, I'll just place the light green. So I have a light green here. I'm gonna add some white. So I'm gonna put reflection on this tree here. So when adding a reflection, you just have to follow everything you see in the top. But you need to make it more horizontal. And also here. Okay, and now the brown color, this will be the light brown. So you have here the umber and white. Just vertical strokes, everyone. Just copy what you see on the top and put it on the bottom. Okay. Yeah. And then I'm gonna use some yellow. And then some browns, so yellow, blue umber, and red. More brownish. Yeah, for this, for the reflection of this one. Yeah, so far it looks good. And then some brownish. Okay. I'll try to put some more holes on these trees, everyone. So blue and white and a little red. Make it more looks purple. And this one. I'll just retouch to create more realistic trees here. Yeah. And now I'm gonna put some waves here, but I'll be using a lighter color. So here I'm gonna put some horizontal waves. Yeah, this will create horizontal strokes. This will create waves on the reflections. So just create horizontal stroke like this. Okay, it's now 1 hour and 22 minutes, and so far I love my progress. It looks good, and I really love the lights on this painting. Very good lighting. Okay, now I'll add more highlights. So waves. So I'll be mixing a lighter color here. I'll be putting it here now. You can use the liner brush if you want. Yeah, just horizontal. And now I'll be adding more white. I'll be using white here. We need some light yellow and red. Because I'm gonna put some horizon here. And also this part here. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, that's it, everyone. So now I'm going to retouch more. I'm gonna find ways to make this more realistic, to make it more look good. So wait a minute. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to continue everyone. I want to add more light here on the reflections. Okay, so I'll use white because I'm gonna retouch here. I'm gonna make it this part lighter. And also here. Okay. And then I'm gonna use this color with more blue and yellow. I'm gonna make this part lighter. To make it look more shining. Yeah, this one really look good, everyone. I like this painting. Okay, so I think I'm gonna put a tree here because there's our shadow here, so I'm gonna put a tree here. Yeah, just one tree so that it will look good. And by doing that, I need to use a darker color. I'll be using this umber with some blue. And I'm gonna put some big leaves on this tree, so I'll be using this brush only. Blue umber, no, blue, yellow, and a little blue umber. So here, I just put like that. Mm-hmm. This part should be really, really thick. Yeah, I'll also add some reddish or brown and some yellowish. To make this very colorful and old. And then I'm going to put some highlights. I'll just use yellow. And then I'm gonna need to put some highlights, of course. So blue umber, yellow and red, and plenty of white. I'll be using now the liner brush. Because I'm gonna put some highlights, a little diffuse highlights on the back part here, on the left side of this tree trunk. I'll put more yellow and red and white. And here I'm gonna put some highlights on this part of the trees here. Okay. Yeah, and the last part, I think I'm gonna put a flying duck here or something. Yeah, just flying, or maybe a boat, that'll be cute. But now I'll just put some flying duck. Yeah, I love the contrast on this one, it's really look cute. The painting looks simple, but it looks realistic. So here's some raw umber. I'm gonna use this one. I'm gonna put some tree trunk and branches. Mm-hmm. I need also to put highlights on these branches here. Okay. Okay, so far everyone, I really love the result of this painting. It looks really great. It looks realistic for me. Okay, I think the last part, I'm going to put a flying bird here. Of course, birds are flying. I'm thinking a bird or a boat. I'm thinking about that. What to put? Yeah, birds also will look good in this one. So maybe I'll just put bird here. But if you want to put boat, then it will be good also. I think some parts are still wet. Okay, so I'm gonna retouch. So I'll just retouch a little. I'm gonna use this purple here with white. I'm gonna put some lights, shades, or whatever. Okay. That's it, everyone. So here I'm gonna put a little trees, a little, I mean, sorry, but I mean a little bushes. Just a little. Also some browns to make it look more. There are soil tracks here. I just want this part to be really look dark. And now I'll put a little details on the. On this, what do you call this one? Pathway, yeah. So I'm gonna put more dark there. Some tiny details to make this one look more realistic, and also the shadows should be realistic. So I'm gonna put a little blue, more bluish. Also put some shadows on the farther part. Yeah. Okay, so it's almost 2 hours, everyone. So I finished it for almost 2 hours. So. I think I am done and contented with this one, so maybe I will just retouch a little. And so far this looks great. I like this, I love the result, and I want to say thank you for watching this video today. So far this is really look good, so hopefully you are learning and you get something out of this so that you can paint on your own. Okay, everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like and some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.